with any new Battle Royale game, there are going to be certain guns in that game that people gravitate towards more than others, and this is no different in Apex Legends. While the weapon sandbox is actually pretty well balanced right now, there are some guns that rise above the rest regardless of playstyle. What is up, everybody? Chaos here, and people have been asking me for this. I'm going to be doing my 10 picks for the 10 best guns in Apex Legends. Now keep in mind, this video is being recorded mid-February of 2019, so naturally, this is subject to change once Respawn starts adding new guns or rebalancing the existing ones, but this list is going to be comprised of the weapon sandbox from launch before any major balancing changes come into play. Also, we're not going to be counting any of the super rare weapons in the game since they, well, they often don't even come into play during entire matches, so it's not really fair to compare them to the guns that you're almost guaranteed to see every game. If that sounds fair and you guys are ready, drop a like. Be sure to let me know what your favorite Apex loadout is, and here we go. This month's giveaway is for a new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is drop a like on this video, be subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications so you never miss an upload. And in the comment section, let me know why you want to win the PS4 and include your Twitter handle so I can contact you if you're the winner. The winner will be announced at the end of the month. At number 10, the G7 Scout. Kicking off my list today is a precision weapon that is very similar to the MK14 from the other first-person shooters and is a variant of the G2 rifles from previous Titanfall games. Now, the G7 Scout is a semi-automatic rifle that runs on light bullets, and while it's pretty awkward to use when you're just using the iron sights, it quickly becomes one of the best mid-range guns in the game once you throw the right optic on it. The Scout is very consistent with its damage and range, and since it's semi-auto, you don't really have to worry about controlling the recoil, since it will recenter on its own in between every shot. Now, the G7 Scout is definitely not a favorite of many players, but those that know how to use it will absolutely rip you apart. RE45. This commonly found weapon is hated by many due to it being yet another pistol and yet another light ammo gun, but this can often lead to people writing it off, when in reality, it's actually a really good close-range gun. The RE45 is a fully automatic pistol with a high rate of fire and pretty modest damage, but it more than makes up for it with its quick reload time, tight hip-fire spread, and its very low recoil while aiming down your sights. In my opinion, the RE45 is actually one of the most underrated guns in the game right now, and if you throw an extended mag on it, it essentially acts as a pocket version of the R99 SMG, and since it runs on light bullets, you'll pretty much never have to worry about running out of ammo. This one is a sleeper, my friends. At number 8, the Longbow DMR. Now, I guess this is the most popular sniper rifle in the game besides the Kraber, which is the legendary. Obviously, it's got really good power, and it makes a comeback from Titanfall 1 and 2. And once again, it's a semi-automatic rifle with high damage and somewhat long reload time to make up for it. Now, when compared to other range weapons in Apex, the Longbow will rip through armor with ease, and since it's part of the sniper rifle class, it can be equipped with longer range optics like 6x or 8x. Now, it's definitely not for everybody, and a lot of people leave it on the ground. But those that know what they're doing with snipers in Apex tend to gravitate towards the Longbow, often even picking it over the Kraber due to its abundance of ammo and its spring potential. And I will say this, I feel something needs to happen with the snipers. I see a lot of feedback from a lot of prominent snipers, and they just don't feel that sniping is rewarding enough in the game yet. So you guys let me know what you think. At number 7, the Hemlock. This 3-round burst rifle is a lot better than many people give it credit for. The Hemlock is a pretty common assault rifle that will fire in 3-round bursts by default, but you can actually swap the fire mode to semi-automatic, at which point it becomes an excellent weapon for tagging people from mid-range. As soon as you pick it up, automatically put it on single fire, okay? Trust me, the Hemlock in semi-auto form has virtually no recoil and an extremely high fire rate cap, allowing you to just spam at people from range and apply constant pressure, and each bullet will deal pretty respectable damage on top of that. Then, if people start charging you, you could swap it over to burst mode and spray a little more, or you can keep it in semi-auto and just keep tap firing. The Hemlock is definitely an underrated weapon if you ask me, and the people that know how good it is, they dominate with it. At number 6, the EVA 8. Many have compared the EVA 8 in Apex Legends to a gray tactical shotgun from Fortnite, and I guess they're kind of correct. However, just like the gray tac in Fortnite, the EVA 8 in Apex can surprise you, and it's still really good at keeping the pressure at close range. By default, it kind of sucks, but if you throw a couple attachments on it and you play to its strengths, it's arguably just as good as the Peacekeeper. Plus, Since it's an auto shotgun, you can spray with it and not have to worry about being super precise or aiming down the sights like you do with the Peacekeeper or the Mozambique. It's not going to be on this list, don't worry. So, while it may not have the raw stopping power that the Peacekeeper has, the EVA 8 is still a great DPS weapon, and it's good for keeping pressure on and preventing enemy revives. And it's really good for busting into places where people are camping. Cracking into the top 5, and I love this gun. The assault rifle of choice is the R301 carbine, otherwise known as the carbine, and it's kind of in between a traditional AR and an SMG. It boasts a high fire rate and low recoil, but also pretty generous range and the ability to swap to semi-automatic. Now, it's arguably the best assault rifle in the game due to its versatility and the fact that it runs on light ammo, so you're never going to run dry. Many people treat this gun as a close-range weapon, getting up in people's faces with it and spraying them down, while others treat it more as a traditional AR by tagging people up and applying pressure from mid-range. But either way you want to do it, whatever your cup of tea is, the R301 is great. It's certainly better than the Flatline and the Hemlock, and with the right attachments, it can be even better than the Scout for precision firing. I think it deserves the number 5 spot. It may have deserved a little higher. At number 4, the R99. Now, this SMG is quickly becoming one of the weapons of choice for streamers and pro players, and it boasts a stupidly high fire rate, generous damage, and surprising low recoil for a weapon that shoots as fast as it does. Now, normally weapons with this kind of DPS will have an insane kick to them, but for some reason, the R99 is actually pretty manageable. The main drawback of the gun is its itty-bitty magazine. By default, the R99 only has 18 rounds in the mag, which you will burn through in like a second and a half. Now, extended mags are pretty much a necessity when you're using a gun, but if you're lucky enough to find one of the higher level magazines, the R99 is more than capable of dropping enemies without having to reload, and it's arguably even better than shotguns at close range, just straight up due to the raw DPS and the spraying potential of the gun. And honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if Respawn ends up nerfing this thing in the next big update. At number 3, one of my favorite guns in the game right now, the Spitfire. Speaking of applying pressure, this is without a doubt the best gun in the game for mid-range pressure. The Spitfire is a big mag LMG with a low rate of fire and low recoil, but hefty damage, and it's one of the scariest weapons in the game to go up against right now. The main problem with the Spitfire is the fact that it runs on heavy ammo, which isn't exactly the most common thing to find, and usually it's the kind of ammo you want to conserve for the precision weapons, but if you have the bullets to spare, this thing is ridiculous. It can seriously screw with enemy composition and planning. Just about anything you throw at the Spitfire, it is going to chew up in a few shots, which makes it great for countering Gibraltar's shield and interrupting lifelines, healing, reviving, so on and so forth. Just be sure to keep an eye on your ammo counter, and it's probably a good idea not to be running any other heavy ammo guns while you're using it. And don't just think this is for mid-range either. You can literally just run in and wreck shop and hip-fire this thing, which I do all the time. At number 2, the Peacekeeper. This lever-action shotgun is insane, and it boasts some of the highest one-shot damage capabilities in the game right now. It's pretty ridiculous on its own, but it gets really crazy when you throw a precision choke on it, and it's dumb, okay? With the choke, the Peacekeeper gains the ability to charge its shot, and when it's fully charged up, it gets ridiculous range, dealing 90-plus damage from 20 feet away or even more. Now, the main drawback of the Peacekeeper is the fact that it's definitely a high-skill weapon, meaning you're going to have to put some time and effort into getting good with it. You'll have to learn the ranges, get good with the aiming, and get the fire rate locked into your muscle memory. Now, it's definitely not a gun for everybody, and it's not a gun you're going to be able to just pick up and be good with. But if you put in the time with getting good with this shotgun, it is absolutely worthy of the number 2 spot on today's list. And at number 1 today, let me know if you agree or disagree. The Wingman, perhaps the most talked about gun in the game right now, and I just unlocked the legendary Death Ray looking camo on this thing. It's great. The Wingman is another one of those high skill weapons that the newer players hate and the more experienced players adore. It's a pistol running on heavy ammo. That's your first clue, okay? Essentially a sci-fi version of a 44 mag or a Desert Eagle. It will deal extremely high damage from pretty much any range, close, far, doesn't matter, making it one of the most versatile guns in the game. And with good aim, this thing is absolutely devastating. When you put the Skull Piercer attachment on it, it gets even worse. The only drawback of the Wingman is the low rate of fire and almost, well, maybe the fact that you can't put any optics higher than a 2x on it. But aside from all those things, those two little things, actually, the gun is godly. And if you have good aim, those drawbacks aren't even going to be an issue for you. So in my opinion, the Wingman is the best gun in the game right now. I want to know if you guys agree or if you disagree. There you go. That is my list of the best Apex guns as of February 2019. Not an easy list to do. Let me know if I got it right or if I got it wrong. Drop a like on the video. Make sure you're subscribed. Turn on those post notifications, and I'll have more Apex content for you guys shortly.